we found something that could be of use to you. Well, here you go, folks.
Hi, everybody. Carl Kasgaard back with you here at Bomber Command Museum. And we're here in the Halifax Bomber Exhibit. And we're going to give you another great show, the Halifax 57 Rescue Show. We're going great guns. We've got a 20-foot container full of Halifax parts coming from England. We've got some more treasures that we found. And I want to introduce you to number one engine ready to run for the Halifax. It's all tuned up. Here is number two engine ready to go for the Halifax, and she's running great. We've got other artifacts here. The instrument panel for the pilot is just over there. You know, folks, all of this is costing us thousands and thousands of dollars, and we need your donations to keep rolling. We're finding treasure all the time, but sometimes it is not cheap. And we will go all over the world to get Halifax treasure and bring it back to Nanton, Alberta to make you a Halifax bomber. So what I'm appealing to you is please send in the donations. You've got the credits showing that it's our charity Halifax 57 Rescue for the Bomber Command Museum of Canada. And we just want you to follow us, like us, and help us with a donation. Now, on today's show, I'm going to take you into the rebuild shop, and you're going to see a Bomb Aimers special, this beautiful treasure to make the Bomb Aimers position of the Halifax bomber, and we've got it for you. So let's head into the rebuild shop, and I'll show you all the goodies we've got. And as you know, we've got a giant 20-foot container with Halifax parts coming from England. And so I'm waiting anxiously for that. It's going to the rebuild shop for the Halifax in Arnprior. Then all the other treasure that's in there, including a brand new Bristol Hercules engine, number four engine for our Halifax, it's all coming. But here's what happened just late last week. Surplus shop phones me and says, Carl, you told us to phone you if you found we found something that could be of use to you. Well, here you go, folks. This is a T1 bomb site computer, which was used for bombing in the Lancaster bomber, the Stirling bomber, and the Halifax bomber. And this is not just a used surplus T1 bomb site computer. This is brand new, out of a box that it was stored in since 1943. And this particular bomb site computer, you can see, we'll show you some details here when we zoom in, but you can see, look, all the original parts are still on, oopsie, and the other parts. And look, there's the factory calibration pages. This is a 1943 unit to be installed in a Lancaster bomber and also in the Halifax bombers in Canadian squadrons later in the war. But what I like about it is brand new, never been in an aircraft, and came straight out of the box. And remember, just like vintage toys, if you have a beautiful condition vintage toy and the box that it came in, then you've got yourself a treasure. Okay, so a little more detail for you. This T1 bombsite computer that fits the Lancaster, the Stirling, and the Halifax. And as you can see here, I've just taken the top off the original factory crate for the T1 bombsite computer. And there's the original stenciling. This box has been sitting in hiding in Calgary for 82 years. This is built in 1943. And when I saw that, I just picked up the box and ran. Yes, I paid money. But the thing is, I was never going to find a bombsite this good for our Halifax.
And it's the brains of the entire bomb aiming sequence. And now we've got it.
Now, I'm going to show you the magic tools of the bomb aimer of Bomber Command. This magic right here. So there's your bomb aimer's special presentation of how it works. I hope you enjoyed that. We've got more information for you. We've got all kinds of contact information. We've got our website. We've got our special fundraising site. But whatever you can afford to donate to us, we will find you more treasure. So stick with us. We leave no Halifax behind.